The government has finally got the Rwanda bill through its final stage, so it's now a matter of going through to get royal assent. And it's at the same time now preparing for a whole range of legal challenges. And Michael Tomlinson has said that illegal channel crossings will not stop until regular flights to Rwanda kick in. If the plan for the Rwanda bill is that it is seen as a deterrent, then presumably the biggest legal challenge that can be made against Rwanda is that it is not deterring migrants. So if the numbers from today continue to go up, there was a large boat that came in today, a number of people died, a number of people were fell off the boat and were drowned in the channel today. And if this continues, then presumably the Rwanda law is not working and can be challenged on that basis. The Rwanda law is now defined by the Prime Minister, by people in government, as being a deterrent. So it needs to be held to that to that principle. If it fails to deter, it fails to work. Therefore, it is, as Yvette Cooper calls it, an expensive gimmick that is not a serious plan to actually tackle the problem. The money that has been lavished on the Rwanda bill, on Suella Braverman's pet project, Priti Patel's pet project, the extension of Theresa May's pet project of a hostile environment, all of this is about money wasted that could have been spent reinforcing our borders, employing new border guards, effecting better deals with Europe, or indeed convening an international conference to redefine the 1951 Refugee Convention. It could have been spent recruiting civil servants to help clear the backlog of migrants caught up in hotels and left in a legal limbo, not just those who have arrived since Suella Braverman started her campaign of legislation. Three laws, none of which have actually produced any form of deterrence, because the figures of people crossing the channel have actually risen rather than reduced in that time.